focus. Ideate. Innovate. Enable.
Hello and welcome to Cure Presents CNBC TV18's Design Masters, powered by Hindware and Berger Easy Clean. Now, this competition provides a unique platform to hunt for the most promising student and professional architects in the country. Narrowed down from over 500 applicants, only the top 6 teams from the students category and the professionals category have made it to the semi-finals round. The test here is to design or redevelop an existing marketplace with an innate Indian character. On the episode today, we take a look at the contestants from the student category as they battle their way through the semi-finals to secure their spot in the final round. The 6 teams competing in the semi-final round from the student category were evaluated on their ideas, their creativity, their viability and applicability by a jury of nationally renowned experts. Only the top 3 made it to the finals. Amongst the jury members were Abha Naren Lamba, conservation architect, Sanjay Puri, principal architect, Sanjay Puri Architects, Ravi Sarangan, founder-director, Edifice, Sunani Bhagwati, President DPA V. Krishnamurthy, VP Marketing Hindware, and Michael Foley, founder Foley Designs and mentor Design Masters. The first team presenting their vision for the great Indian marketplace was Mohammad Javed and Mona Kohinoor, students of architecture, Jamia Millia Islamia, New Delhi. Their project, relayering Manik Chowk, Ahmedabad.
The reason why we picked up the particular site is because it holds a very strong background in terms of culture, which dates back to like more than 600 years of age. And it is still thriving very vibrantly as a very dynamic public square, which still is like a commercial hub to the present community around it and to the rest of Ahmedabad. One of the major issues that we have highlighted here are that because it lies in the heritage zone, there's a lot of encroachment, illegal parking, which has led to a lot of conflict zones because the paths are not very well defined amongst the vehicular and pedestrian zones, and there's a loss of historical essence. Our vision primarily focused on reclaiming the urban public square in a way that it re-establishes the long-lost essence of architecture and culture in the place. We also aim to reinvent the identity of the place in such a way that it reunites the community pride and it becomes like a city image to the rest of the Ahmedabad city. Our basic proposal is to develop a city image that would actually have an amalgamation of ethnic diversities of India as well as social integration, which is kind of getting lost in the place. Altogether, it has to have an impact on the society because we've taken care of the needs of the present generation and inspired from the history of the Manik Chowk.
If you were to highlight one significant design feature in the new design which you have done, what would it be?
The merge of the Indian architecture as well as the modern architecture, which is very important. You can't just leave it to heritage alone. You need to signify both the aspects because technology is growing, so is the world.
So what differentiation from your concept perspective would make it something that would draw today's shoppers?
So what we thought we'll incorporate, first we'll open the heritage to everybody because it's a huge tourist attraction. And if you draw the crowd, you have to accommodate the crowd. So we need to make spaces. If the crowd comes, it needs to be spread out apart from the shopping complex.
There is no new building proposal to be done in this.
No, sir. What basically we've done is we have not demolished anything because there was nothing worth demolishing. Everything has an essence there.
The judges were very encouraging. In fact, it's like they don't make you feel nervous. And when they appreciate you, you feel like speaking more. That gives you confidence.
The next team competing for the win were Nithyam Chaurasia and Harshit Raj Kotia, students of architecture, Madhav Institute of Technology and Science, Gwalior. Their project, kinetic modules created with shipping containers for Phoolbagh, Gwalior.
Hello everyone. Without wasting your time, here I present my presentation on Indian street vendors.
The pitch was focused on providing an efficient solution for street vendors who are over 1 crore in number and contribute greatly to the Indian GDP. The team devised prototypes of kinetic modules for these vendors, created with compartmentalized shipping containers. Each container can be manipulated to create an individual makeshift store, or two or more containers can be combined to create a larger space. The ultimate vision was to create an entire container market in Phulbag, Gwalior.
So, आप ये जो marketplace create कर रहे हैं, consumer को attract करने के लिए. Marketplace is all about commerce. Transaction होना चाहिए. तो attraction के लिए जो consumer आएगा, उसके लिए क्या architecture क्या role play कर सकता है? आपका architecture?
Gwalior में single side traffic movement है. तो हमने एक movement को उसमें चेंज किया है. तो यदि फूलबाग जो रीजन है उसमें सारे मतलब सारे ट्रैफिक आके मतलब कंट्रीब्यूट करते हैं उसके ट्रैफिक को, तो वहां पे सारे लोग अभी भी इकट्ठे होते हैं. वहां पे सारे स्टूडेंट्स हैं, फैमिलीज हैं, हेरिटेज है जो कि अभी मतलब प्रॉपर यूज नहीं हो रहा है.
तो अभी फिलहाल फूलबाग में कॉमर्स नहीं होता है?
या होता है,
होता है
स्ट्रीट वेंडर्स
से होता है. तो आप आर्किटेक्चरली इसको एक पोजीशन देने
ये बहुत ही इनोवेटिव प्रपोजल था आपका. जो आपका प्रपोजल मॉड्यूल पे बेस्ड है, तो आप क्या समझते हैं फूलबाग के लिए किस कितने लेवल्स आप प्रपोज कर रहे हैं? सिंगल, डबल, फाइव लेफ्ट?
मैम अभी फ्यूचर में वहाँ पे प्रपोजल है स्काई वॉक का और रोप वे का, तो अप्रोक्स 4 to 5 फ्लोर.
जजेस जो हैं हम लोग पहले उनसे हैंडल कर चुके हैं, मिल चुके हैं, और काफ़ी अच्छे मतलब उनका वर्क भी बहुत अच्छा है, और अंडरस्टैंडिंग मतलब स्टूडेंट के प्रोजेक्ट को समझने का जो अंडरस्टैंडिंग है वो बहुत अच्छा है.
As far as the students are concerned, it's more of the thinking process and the attempt to do something rather than the actual solution that we have considered.
Simplicity was important. How fundamental the idea is, what foundation they build the concept on. I think that for me was most important.
With that, it's time for a short break. On the other side, we bring you more action from the Great Indian Marketplace Challenge on Design Masters. Stay tuned. Welcome back. You're watching part one of the semi-finals of Design Masters. Now let's take a look at the rest of the teams as they pitched their ideas for the Great Indian Marketplace Challenge. The third team to present to the jury were Isha Jain and Amy Joseph, students of architecture, Jamia Millia Islamia, New Delhi. Their project, redevelopment of Asia's largest wholesale spice market, Khari Bauli, Shahjahanabad.
The basic types of things that you'll find in this market is you have spices, you have pulses, you have all the dairy products that are used in everyday kitchen households, and you have utensils kind of a thing.
About the weakness, basically there's this traffic congestion, which is the basic problem, and parking of course. Poor quality pedestrian infrastructure sends a message that you are really unwelcome to the place. So what we have done is we have taken into account both the big picture as well as the small intangible details, that is how a structure is made, as well as to the material under the feet. So, and we have focused basically on conserving the visual and the aromatic identity of the spice market, which is associated, or the pedestrians associate with it. We have a pedestrian path, which is, we have again color-coded them in order to identify which lane you are going through. We have reclaimed those green spaces to give it a breathing space. And we have retained the old character of the place, that is introducing old charokas. We have also given rooftop cafes at the top of the at the top, so you can have a scenic view as of the Fatehpuri Masjid, which is just adjacent to it.
You didn't think of taking the vehicular traffic away and trying to create something which was more sort of pedestrian oriented?
Ma'am, the actual scenario is that it's semi-vehicular street, and you have only the commercial vehicles that are coming in, and that too just for loading and unloading.
I think it's a great effort because you've done this bit of shadowing each business transaction, the business vendor, and allocated spaces for them. It's a great effort.
The judges were really supportive of our design and they commended us also. And they were really friendly people to talk to, as in I did get nervous, but yeah, it was very good.
Next up were Dipesh Sangtani and Mohammad Adil Hussain, students of architecture, Jamia Millia Islamia, New Delhi. Their project, Design Ideation of Meena Bazaar, Delhi.
The design is actually user-based design. So we identify the users first. We have users like shopkeepers, local visitors, foreign tourists, and the Rain Basera dwellers, if you can see there in the Urdu Park. We actually sum down the problems that we have. It is littering, the first one. Second is disorderliness. Third is uncomfort. Lack of facilities, obviously. That is lighting and toilet that makes it unsafe for women and children. First of all, we created a clear visual access from one end to the other so that they, you can clearly see Jama Masjid. What we actually propose is transforming the bazaar chairs. That is the first intervention. We have the flexible shop modules, as you can see there. It opens up, it closes down at night, so that at night it can be used as food courts. Then we have, cleared the encroachments of the Jama Masjid and we gave it an order. If you can see the stairs there. Then we have a clear line of sight. Generation of recreational spaces. Our concept was actually, why market be only a market? Market plus recreation will give it a better function. We revitalized the Urdu Park that was completely dead. This is the water channel. We use the wazu facility ka jo pani hai. We channelized it into the water channel. It goes into the groundwater. So groundwater se wo, so I expect ki agle 50 saal mein groundwater hamara increase ho sakta hai.
The systems that you have, like a kiosk, yes. Are there more than one type of vendor using it in a day?
Sir, it's actually commodity-based module. If you see, jisme teen steps hain, that is actually for shoes. Kyunki unko aadat hai, wo dabbo ke upar stack karke rakhte hain. The two, jo do step wala hai, that is actually for clothes. Kyunki wo alag-alag, matlab bachcho ke ya phir ladko ke kapde alag-alag. Jo single wala hai, that is for normal, jo ki aam use ke liye hai.
Is this area completely clear for this intervention that you all have done, or have you all looked at clearing up parts of it?
No, we are not clearing. Jo dukane abhi hain, we have the same number of shops. We just organized it in a manner.
The judges were great. They really liked the idea. They were helpful. They weren't really critical about it, but then they just wanted to know how it would act to the end users at the last point, like to the design, how would it act to the end users.
I was primarily looking at it from the design content. What is so innovative in terms of the design solution being recommended? Looking at the problem in hand. That was the key solution I was looking at. And what are the fundamental design which they were looking at?
As a jury, I was expecting lateral thinking, out-of-the-box thinking, redefining the marketplace. I was happy to state that some of those entries did excite us.
On that note, it's time for a short break. But don't go anywhere as we reveal the winners from the student category of the semi-finals when we return. Stay tuned. Welcome back to Cure Presents CNBC TV18's Design Masters, powered by Hindware and Berger Easy Clean. Now let's jump straight back into the action as we watch the final presentations from the students and the much-awaited moment when the winners from the semi-final round are revealed. The next team, Sujit Walat and Rahul Sasindran, students of Architecture, College of Architecture, Trivandrum. Their project, redesign of Konimara Market, Travancore, Kerala.
Dated 1857 and named after the Madras governor Konimara, who inaugurated the market in 1870s. The problem we identified are circulation, accessibility, confusion and space wastage, which is the problem of zoning and drainage and lack of hygiene. And this is the proposed zoning in which we have shifted the parking area towards to the back, which is the dump yard. And this is the master plan in which parking. And we have a well-defined space for the service loading and unloading, which doesn't affect the circulation.
While designing, we are considering some factors such as for a fancy store, we have more exhibition spaces and we need more accessibility from both sides. That's mainly we considered in the fancy store. Then we are moving to the fish stall. The single unit of a fish stall can accommodate 4 persons. And there is a central drainage system. The restaurant is a space which links the city side and the market side. The two sides of the restaurant is open to the city side and two is to the market.
Do any of these structures have any heritage or social or community values which means that they may be associated with certain trades, certain systems of transaction over the years, which people associate with.
Okay, we could identify only the kin system, which is used in the vegetable and fruit stall, where the ripened fruits are stored.
What is the condition of these structures? Which the pictures are not very clear. They are temporary structures currently, or are they heritage structures, or are they tin sheets?
It's actually temporary structures with tin sheet and also tarpaulin.
So it's currently haphazard. And what you are proposing is an
it's
architecture?
Not actually having a proper zoning. It's lacking. We have some feeling about, some romance about some spaces that we see outside the college and all. So bringing out those ideas definitely needs some platform. And that's what the Design Masters Challenge is all about.
The sixth and final person to present to the jury, Krishna Sirugudi, student of architecture, VNIT, Nagpur. His project, Design of Fool Market, Nagpur.
The concept is traditional configuration and a modern appeal. This is the site plan actually. At the back, there are the FSI files, which I stacked up because of the development practicality that it has to come up. The sectorial market is in the front, and there is a multi-utility ground at the site, and there is a parking tower in the corner, in the north side. I would like to diversify the user group so that there are more people coming in, and it's more of a public market. There's a open level plaza at the second floor on the right side of the screen. There's a open utility ground. There's a parking tower on the left. For a market like this to work, there should be a good amount of policies and technological integration. So a docking bay that lifts up in the multi-utility parking space, retractable bolas to control time and vehicular traffic, e-ink canopy that casts Skyography as an advertisement to boost commercial activities.
What is the existing condition of this market? Because I haven't, and what is your intervention doing to this
existing condition of the market is, it actually functions in the early morning itself. It's a wholesale market, and it's usually people come in for their needs only. It's not a recreational space. It fades out at 12 in the afternoon itself.
Is there anything of the existing that you are sort of building it into your scheme, or is it all completely new?
It's completely new, but the justification I would give that, I preserved the entity of the market and the identity. The revision was needed because the existing structure bifurcates the site totally, so it can't be revised right there.
Well, it's a very well thought of scheme, and you have, you know, almost thought of most of the parameters that govern and come up with good solutions.
From an architectural aesthetics perspective, can you just explain a little as to what connects it, say, to Nagpur, or what makes it unique to this place?
Actually, I worked out this presentation this way, or the design this way, because I can control the design of my plot, but I can't control the development around me. In future, the development might go out of context in my case. So the proportions and the feel and the configuration is kept local, but the approach is global, or rather Indian, which is coming up right now. So it blends both ways. I would say that I haven't seen such a platform for architects till now. It's a great way to connect to people. It's a great way to let people know your ideas and how well you do. It's a great idea itself to learn more and make people learn.
After much deliberation, the jury selected the top teams from the semi-final round and announced the winners of the Great Indian Marketplace Challenge, who would move on to the finals. First up were team number 2, Nithyam Churasia and Harshid Raj Kotia, students of architecture, Madhav Institute of Technology and Science, Gwalior.
It was a tough platform for future architects, because abhi sab jo abhi life cycle hai student ki, वो यही है कि सब लोग देखना चाहते हैं कि हम कैसे काम कर रहे हैं, आगे क्या होगा, आगे हमारा फ्यूचर सिक्योर है कि नहीं है. तो उसके हिसाब से ये प्लेटफॉर्म बहुत अच्छा है, जिसको उनसे अपना फ्यूचर सिक्योर दिखने लगता है और वो अच्छा काम करने लगता है.
Next is team number 4, Deepesh Sangtani and Mohammad Adil Hussain, students of architecture, Jamia Millia Islamia, New Delhi.
It feels really great, and it's quite a big opportunity. If we do win,
we would keep up to the intervention we're still making, and maybe work more on it, and not only this project but maybe for other marketplaces as well.
And finally, Team 6, Krishna Sirugudi, student of architecture, VNIT, Nagpur.
Firstly, having a jury like that and having so much positive to expect, it really ended up and culminated really well at the end. Design Masters has given me a great opportunity to work out and to learn and to make people know how I think. That's the best part about it.
I think a platform like Design Masters gives budding architects as well as young students a very interesting outlet to be able to demonstrate their design, to be able to challenge themselves, and to get a wider platform to showcase their design skills. And I think this is a very good way of encouraging new talent and bringing that level of recognition to young talent, and to be able to propel them to, you know, a greater height.
It's an excellent platform, personally speaking, from both the QO point of view, CNBC's point of view, and principal sponsor QO and HindiWorld point of view. We are trying to build a platform for the budding architect and the young student to showcase their talent, which could be a platform where they can come forward and actually showcase what they can actually deliver in their professional life when they get into.
That's all we have on this edition of Design Masters. But do join us again next week as we introduce the contestants from the professional category and reveal which three teams will make it to the finals. Until then, from the entire team, many thanks for watching.
Focus. Ideation. Innovate. Enable.